Hey Cafe crew, it's Colin Smith here from Photoshop Cafe, and this week I'm going to show you how to combine two photographs together inside of Adobe Photoshop. It seems like this is an area that people trip up a lot, so I'm going to do a tutorial on it right now and just kind of answer all those questions once and for all, is how do you combine two photos? So there's a couple of different ways of doing it. The easiest way to do it inside of Photoshop CC is to click and hold on the photograph that you want to bring into the other one. Then move your mouse right up till you see the other one appear. Move your mouse or your pointer, if you're holding a Wacom, over the top. If you hold down the shift key, it'll center it. And now release. And notice what we've done is we've now got both the photographs there inside of two layers on top of each other so we can combine them. But let's go back and I'm going to show you some other things. So if we choose under here, notice there's a thing called application frame. Now, this is only on the Mac. You won't find this on the Windows. So if I turn application frame off, notice that these are kind of just floating and I can take a photo and drag it into the second one. Notice we've combined them. Okay, so let's go back to the application frame, turn it back on again, because in Windows, you're not going to have that option. You don't have the floating windows like you do on the Mac. Okay, so here's another way that we can do it is if we choose window and then we choose arrange. And it just changed this to say two up vertical. Now we can see the two documents side by side. Click and drag in one, move over to the other one, hold shift for centering and release it. So let me just go back here. We're gonna go back to arrange and then we're gonna go consolidate all the tabs and it just takes everything back to where it was. All right, so now I'm gonna create a little composite really quickly combining these two photos. So I'm gonna do it this way, which is my preferred method. Click. Move up to the tab of the destination, hold down shift, release. Then I'm gonna hit Control T or Command T. That brings up the free transform. But notice that the photo that we put in here is so much bigger, we can't see those handles. If I zoom out, eventually you'll see those handles. So there's a quick way to do that, and that's just hit Control Zero. And it would be Command Zero on Mac, and it will zoom out till you see those handles. And now I can go in the corner, hold down the shift key, and drag it out proportionally. If I also hold the option key, it will drag it out from the center, and now we can get it to kind of match there. There we go, and I'm just gonna hit enter to apply it. All right, so I'm just gonna go a little bit bigger now. So what we need to do though, is we need to combine these two photographs together so it kind of looks like this is over the top of it. So we could actually just paint it out with a mask. That's one way of doing it, but I'll show you another way. Why don't we just grab the quick select tool. Now I'm just going to go over there and notice what I've done is I dragged it and I've just selected all this area over the top. If I hit Command-Shift-I, or I'll show you under here, go under the Select, and under Select go Inverse Selection, which you can see is Command-Shift-I on Mac, Control-Shift-I on Windows. Now we're just selecting our area here. Now it didn't really matter, I just wanted to show you that because I want to show you how to inverse a selection. Now we're just going to create a mask. With this area selected, go down to the mask icon and we're going to click. Now, if we hadn't inversed the selection, we could get exactly the same result by holding option and then clicking. And it will mask the area that we see now. But instead, I'm just going to click on the mask area and notice now it's masking it there. All right, so I'm not going to go like super in depth here into showing you how to, you know, make this absolutely perfect. I just want to kind of give you the tips. So notice we've got a little bit of a hard edge. We could just do a little cheat here thing by just going up onto the layer, selecting that layer mask, double click it to open the properties panel if it's not already open. And then we just push feather a little bit. And we're just gonna soften that edge. See that? Just to kind of soften it off. And we've got to select it. Now in the real world, I would use select a mask and I've got other tutorials and stuff like that on there. But I'm trying to just show you some basic principles here. Okay, so the colors here, they've got this kind of red kind of color cast, and on the other side there's a kind of a blue color cast. So here's how you would deal with that. Select our just one of our layers. Let's grab the background actually, because we want to change this. So how do we match it? Here's a quick way. We go to Image Adjustments, and then go down to Match Color. Now here's our match color. And what we want to do is we want to choose our source. And our source is going to be this image, which is Lake Jackson's JPEG that I grabbed from Adobe Stock. And the layer that I want to use now is actually going to be layer 1. That's the one I want to grab the colors from. So notice when I do that, it applies the colors from this layer onto the other one. Of course, right now it looks a little bit strong, so we just want to bring it back. And we can do that with the fade slider. So if we take the fade slider down a little bit, we can combine it till the colors sort of match. We can also play around with color intensity, which will make it less saturated or more saturated. And then, of course, luminance will just lighten it up a little bit or darken it up to match the image that we want to match on the top. So we can just go down like that. Now, in real life, this is actually often a distance, so it would have less color than the other one. So here's another little tip that you can do when you're doing this kind of work and you want to kind of combine things together. What we can do is we can actually just add a color over the whole thing. So if we just go here and we choose solid color and we want to give it some kind of a cinematic look, I don't know, let's give it a nice kind of an orangey glow. And then we change this to, this is the color layer, change this to color blend mode. There's other ways we can do this, of course. And then if we pull the opacity all the way down and then just give it a little smidge, just give it a little touch, there we go. And notice what it does by dripping this color down onto the other two layers. It kind of merges them all together and gives them this kind of a nice feel. So don't forget, if you like this, hit that like button right now. Become part of the Cafe crew. Hit the subscribe button. And every single week, I'll get you a new tutorial on Photoshop, Lightroom, and different types of gadgets. So anyway, guys, add a comment. Let's get a discussion going. Thanks for watching. And until next week, I'll see you at the cafe.